Hello students, how are you? Hope you are fine. So today we are going to do a very interesting experiment. So what is that? Today we are going to discuss about magnetic induction. So what do you mean by magnetic induction? Magnetic induction is a process by which an object or a material is magnetized. So today we are going to magnetize a soft iron material. There are three ways to magnetize. What are those three ways? First is single touch method, second is double touch method, and third one is electromagnetic induction. So today we are going to discuss about single touch method. So for that, what are the things required? First, let's see what are the things required. First, you require one bar magnet. Next, you require one needle or an iron nail. It will be your soft iron. Next, some iron paper clips to test whether your magnet has become a magnet or not. Some straw pieces, a container, and water. So these are the materials required. So let me tell you one thing, that whatever the magnet we will make with the help of magnetic induction, you will make a temporary magnet, and it's a very weak magnet. It's not so strong as a bar magnet you have right now. Let's do the activity. What do you have to do? First, you have to place the iron nail horizontally on your tabletop. Then hold the nail from one side so that it does not move. Hold with your hand. And then bring a magnet, a bar magnet, near to this iron nail. And touch only one pole of the magnet. Let's suppose I am touching the north pole of the magnet to this nail, to this one end of the nail where I am holding it. And while doing, you will keep the magnet in an inclined position. Don't keep it straight or keep it horizontal. No. You will keep it in an inclined position and don't ever change the pole of the magnet. When you are doing with north pole, you do it with north pole. If you are doing with south pole, then you will continue with the south pole only. This point of the nail is A and this point is B. So we will drag this magnet on the nail from point A to point B. So you touch the north pole of the magnet to point A and then drag it and reach point B. When you reach point B, then you lift the magnet and then again put the magnet to point A. Then again drag it. Like this, you have to stroke the magnet on this nail for several times, maybe 50 to 60 times. After completing 50 to 60 strokes, you just turn the nail a little bit, come to the back side of the nail, then again follow the same steps for 50 to 60 times. So when you will complete, you will find and you will observe the nail has become a magnet, a temporary magnet, a weak temporary magnet. Now bring these paper clips and bring your iron nail that you magnetize right now in near this paper clips, and you will find that yes, see, this magnet, these paper clips are attracted by the nail. That means your nail has become a magnet. Nail is made up of soft iron and the soft iron is magnetized due to single touch method. So this is the single touch method. Now let's do it again with the needle. First, you take this needle, place it on the top of the table, hold it from one side as you have done with the nail. Same thing you will do with the needle. Do it for 50 to 60 times. So after 50 to 60 strokes, you will find that your needle also become a magnet. Now to test that your needle has become a magnet, what you do, pass this needle through the straw pieces like this. You can see. Take this beaker, put some water into it. Now what you will do, you will put this needle on the water in the container and you will find that this needle will always align in north and south direction, and this shows that it has already become a magnet. Definitely it has become a weak and temporary magnet. If you change the direction, then also it will come and align in a particular direction, north and south. That means this has become a magnet, it has a north and south pole. Now if I bring any pole of the bar magnet that I have near this needle, then what will happen? You just observe it very carefully, that if the pole of the needle and the pole of the magnet is different, then it will attract, and if the pole of the magnet and the pole of the needle is same, then it will repel. You can see, it's very interesting. That's it. So now we have understood, and we already know that repulsion is the surest test for magnetism. So this has become a magnet, it is for sure. Try this several times, you will find it very interesting. You can do it at your home. These are the things that is easily available at your home. You can find any magnet, a needle is there, take a beaker, water, everything you can do. You will find it everything at your home. You can do it. It's very interesting. So try to find it out. So how did you like it? Isn't it very interesting? Why these magnetic materials getting attracted or magnetized to become a magnet? What is the reason behind it? Now I am showing you the reason that is for your understanding only. Okay, so let's see. So this is a magnet, and this is not a magnet or a magnetic material. The magnet has a north and south pole. Inside this magnet, you can find that there are small blocks, and all the blocks have a north and south pole. And in a magnet, all the blocks are arranged in a particular way. All the north pole will show a particular direction. In this direction, all the north poles will be there, and in this direction, all the south poles will be there. So this is a magnet. Now in magnetic materials also, there are small blocks where the north and south pole, but they are arranged haphazardly. They are not arranged in a particular manner. So when you bring a magnet near this magnetic material, what happens? All the blocks inside the magnetic material will align in a particular direction. If I bring the north pole of the magnet near this magnetic material, so all the south pole will be attracted, will be aligned in this direction. And north pole will be in the opposite direction, because north and north are repelling each other, and north and south attracted each other. And if I take it away, again the blocks of the magnetic material will return to its previous positions. Now if you keep this magnet for a longer period of time or drag the magnets on it, then the blocks in the material, magnetic material, will continue to be in these positions for a certain period of time. That means it has become a temporary magnet. Have you understood why these magnetic materials become magnet and why these are attracted? Now suppose there is a non-magnetic material. Suppose there is a material that is not magnetic. They will not attracted by the magnet, like plastic. They also have some blocks like this. Okay, but if I bring any magnet near it, these blocks does not move. That's why they are not get attracted. So that is the reason non-magnetic materials are not attracted by the magnet, and this reason only the magnetic materials are getting attracted by the magnet, and they are magnetized also. Questions may come that can we rub it in the middle? No, we cannot rub it in the middle, because if you rub it in the middle, then what will happen? That all the blocks will be aligned in both the direction. Okay, in the middle, towards middle. Okay, from this side, all the blocks will direct in this direction, and from this side, all the blocks will direct in this direction. Then the magnet will not create, because there must be a polarity. It will create one polarity, that north pole this side, south pole this side. Okay, but in that situation, it will not be able to create any pole, so that it will not get magnetized. So this is the reason that from center we cannot rub it. We have to rub from one end to another end, and then lift the magnet, and then again start from the first point, then rub it. Okay, like this you will have to continue doing this for several times, and then you will get your desired result. Hope you have understood and you find it very interesting, and you can do it at your home. So thank you all of you, and have a good day. Thank you.